Hi, I'm Angie. Welcome to RV 360 by National Indoor RV Centers, where we have all the details on the latest coaches. NIRVC is a trusted resource with RV lifestyle specialists who are here to help you find your dream coach. NIRVC also supports you well after the sale with storage, service, and detailing. So basically, we do it all. Hi, I'm Angie with National Indoor RV Centers, and today I'm so excited to show you the 2025 Holiday Rambler Admiral 24M. So you are going to love this coach. One of the things, it's very versatile. And so as I walk around, you'll see why I say that. Now I have a couple of assignments for you. First of all, I love to show you the coach. I love to help you do your research, but guess what I love to do even more? I love to sell these coaches. So make sure you give us a call at National Indoor RV Centers. We have RV lifestyle specialists that are ready and waiting that wanna help you put you in the right coach. We're not gonna be high pressure. We will help you custom order something if we don't have exactly what you want. So let us help you get into this RV and lifestyle. The second thing I wanna ask you is give me your comments. Let me know if I showed you what you wanted to see, if there's something I left out, please let me know because you'll only help improve these videos. And then thirdly, I don't wanna hear, well, we didn't live by one of your locations. We have 6 locations currently across the United States, and we have a fly to buy program. So if you're not in one of our locations, we will fly you to where we have the coach so you can take delivery, stay with us for a couple nights, and learn all about your coach. Let me tell you, it's the best experience. So no excuses. Make sure you give us a call at National Indoor RV Centers. So check out the very top of the coach. We've got our marker lights, and then we have this massive windshield. That's what you get to see this beautiful country through. Your windshield wipers. We have the Holiday Rambler emblem here, which I love. And then we've got our LED headlights, so you have a clear view of everything as you're traveling down the road. The Admiral sits on the Ford F53 chassis with the 7.3 liter V8 engine. So that's your Godzilla engine. So you got to come out and drive it and see how it performs. Then let's just look underneath the front cap here. So right inside here, we've got our horn. Then we have our power steering fluid, our windshield wiper fluid, the air intake for the engine. And then right in front of us here, we have the cooling package. So we have our radiator system. So this one that looks kind of like a shoebox down here is the radiator for the power steering. And then our radiator for the transmission, radiator for our AC, and then our engine radiator in the very back. Now, just a little radiator maintenance. Once you get to the resort or park that you're going to, you're gonna wanna wash off your windshield and your front cap so that you don't have any pesky bugs trying to eat through your beautiful paint job. And then also you're gonna open this up and your radiator is gonna be filled with debris, bugs, as you've been traveling. So you just wanna take a garden hose and just put your thumb over the end and gently rinse that off so that they can just work more efficiently. Chassis batteries. And then our coolant. And then if you look behind this red panel right here, you can see that we have a line coming from our chassis battery. And this is really where your battery boost button that I'm gonna talk about when I'm at the dash, you're gonna bring your chassis battery and your house batteries together to give you extra power to start your coach if you ever come back to a dead battery. This beautiful exterior is the Thunder color. There are 2 other colors that you can choose from. Also wanna let you know that Holiday Rambler only uses a one-piece fiberglass wall. So no wood, no wood backer, no luan in this. So you're not gonna have to worry about delam of your sidewalls. We have our chrome exterior mirrors. They are internally controlled other than this bottom part, which you've gotta manually adjust once you're in the driver's seat. Have your co-pilot out here so you can get that just right. Your mirrors are so important when you're driving. And then you've got your side camera. So when you turn on your right blinker, you're gonna be able to see down the full right side of your coach, same with the left side of your coach. And then we've got our turn signal here, indicator here and here. So our marker lights and turn signals. Then you're gonna see this window here. This is your pet window. So as you're traveling down the road, you can take your pet with you. They get a view of everything that's happening as well. And then we've got the Continental 245/70/19.5 tires on this coach to travel along the road with. And we've got our step that extends when your door opens. Front door with a nice big window. got our porch light here and our handlebar there to safely get in and out of the coach. So I also want to extend the awning so we have some nice shade on a sunny afternoon. So right inside the door, I'm gonna go ahead and put the awning out. So now you can see the nice big awning. Just something about the awning too. When it is in, you can adjust it so that you can adjust the angle of the pitch so that it, so that if you have a big rainstorm, that the water will flow off the far corner than rather right here in front of the step. And you have a light. So look how cool that is. And you can just adjust that where that light's shining by just putting the awning in and out a little bit to get the right angle. So a little awning safety by Angie. I personally only like to extend my awning and use it when I am outside in the space around my coach. I never want to leave my awning out when I leave the coach, because you just never know when a huge, you know, Mother Nature is unpredictable at times and a huge gust of wind can come. And I've seen it, you know, pull awnings all the way over across on the other side of the coach. So not a good thing. So word to the wise, I would just say use your awning when you're outside in the space. Otherwise, keep it in. Now that we've got our awning out, we've got the nice LED lighting, I want to watch a little TV. So check out this. Look at this huge TV, 50-inch Sansu TV. I've never seen an exterior TV that's 50-inch. So this is really nice. You've got speakers here, 2 110 outlets and 2 USB charging ports. So now we have our TV, we have our entertainment. What's left? We need some food and drink, right? So look at this, our outdoor kitchen. I absolutely love this. So we have our refrigerator and little mini freezer there, but you can keep all the drinks out here. Then you've got a prep space and a drawer. Below that, you've got a microwave. We've got the sink area here and storage below here, a little bit. 2 110 outlets and then our water pump. We can turn it on from right here. And then our low point drains, we can turn those off from there. Our sink, residential faucet, more storage, and then storage up above, which goes all the way back. And you've got one available 110 outlet, bottom and top. And then down below, we've got a quick connect so you can grill, you've got your drinks, got your sink, your TV, your awning. That's why I say this is such a versatile coach, because you really, it's set up to go tailgating. Now let's check out some storage. So we have a nice big compartment here. We've got the Rotocast compartment and you've got 2 110 outlets here, and you can thread that cord through here so you can still shut this compartment and keep it totally safe from critters getting in. And then you've got your 1000 pure sine wave inverter inside here with your disconnect switches. So if we're not lucky enough to have you as one of our storage customers at National Indoor RV Centers, where we store over 300 coaches indoor at all of our permanent locations, where you're always plugged into 50 amp service, you don't need to worry about batteries going dead, then you wanna make sure you are hitting your battery disconnects and your inverter disconnects so you don't have any parasitic drop. We're prepped for a solar panel. So if you have a portable solar panel, you can add that in here as well. And then check out that pass-through space. That's really nice if you've got longer items. So big compartment with pass-through space. Notice the beautiful frameless tinted windows. And then we have our exhaust for our furnace. Next compartment houses our 14-gallon propane tank, marker light. And then right here, we've got, this is key. I've already opened it for us, but this is where we would gravity fill our freshwater tank if we need to put potable water in here. This is also where you can sanitize your tank. Our last marker light for the passenger side of the coach. And then right here in the bumper, dual purpose for your bumper. This is where you can store your stinky slinky. So this black part comes out and you could store the stinky slinky or sewer hose in here. Now right here, you're gonna see a little rough spot. That's where you can step up to go up on your ladder so you can check out your TPO roof. So across the top rear cap, we've got our marker lights, and right in the center, we have our camera, our nice big bedroom window. That's one of the things that I do love about gas coaches is that you usually get a nice big window in your master bedroom. So that's great. Then our hide brake lights and our bumper. Then we've got our hitch here. It is a hitch rating for 8,000 pounds and a tongue weight of 800 pounds. And your 7-way for your tow vehicle. And then right here, you're gonna see an exhaust. That's gonna be for your generator. As I come around the driver's side, we've got our tank flush, and then our city water fill, and our marker light. Behind this panel is our 5,500 watt Onan generator. That's an upgrade, so that's an optional feature. So we upgraded that with the two ACs that are inside. And then we've got our fuel fill for our 80 gallon fuel tank, marker light, and engine exhaust. Now right at the top here, we've got the exhaust for our water heater. So here's our wet bay. We have our black tank and our gray tank, our T-bar for the black, T-bar for the gray. And then this is where we're gonna connect our stinky slinky, put it right through there, seal off this compartment, and then connect it to the park sewer. So if you're not sure how to do all this, make sure you check out my RVing 101 video, and I'll teach you how I do all that. We've got our water filter for the coach. Our freshwater tank in this coach is 50 gallons, 37 for the black, 37 for the gray, and then we've got our low point drains. Then we have our exterior shower, and we've got a little cutoff switch here right at the faucet, which is nice. So you can, if you're gonna take a military shower, that's an easy way to do it. Then you have your hot and your cold, and it just fits nicely in that compartment and it locks shut. And our last compartment, we have a nice big compartment. Again, this is going to be our pass-through compartment, and we've got our 50 amp shore power cord, which we can thread right through here so we can close our compartment and keep it safe from the critters. We have our RV SureGuard protection transfer switch here. So one of the things I do highly, highly recommend is that you have a second surge guard protector. This will protect you one time, crazy weather, park electricity, you wanna have a second. So you can either do one at the end of the cord, or you can have National Indoor RV Centers wire one right into this compartment for you. And then we've got our pass-through compartment, and then we have our park cable and our portable satellite cable, and a port right here for our cables. And we've got a heated compartment. You can see the vents there, so you can keep it a good temperature down here. Then we have our last marker light and turn signal indicator here and here. All right, so now I've shown you the beautiful outside. Let's go check out the interior. As I step into the Admiral, a couple things that I love. First of all, you have this great grab bar, so you can safely get in and out of the coach. Next up is our fire extinguisher. Now that's super important. Great that it's right there by the entrance door, so you can use it outside or inside. Personally, I don't think it's sufficient for a coach of this size. So go and check out my video on Proteng fire suppression system. If you know anything about National Indoor RV Centers, we only promote and sell products that we truly, truly believe in. Watch the video and then give us a call. We can give you a custom quote for your specific coach. To my right, I have a whole bunch of things to talk about here. First of all, we have the porch light, which is right outside our entry step. So this is super important. When you get to your resort, you want to make sure you turn off that step so that it stays extended, so that every time you open the door, it doesn't go in and out and just needlessly using that motor. Then we have our entry light, which is right here. We have our light for our awning and our awning controls in and out. And then our Magnum. So we have a 1000 watt inverter. This is our Magnum inverter. This is a remote switch, so we can turn it on and off from here. So that's really nice to have right as you walk in and out of the coach. Then over here we have, we can see our tank levels here. So it's gonna give you the gauge, the levels here, low, fair, good, and you need to charge it or it's full here. So our fresh tank, gray, black, LP tank, main battery, and chassis battery. Then down below here, we have our water heater for our LP and our water heater for our electric and our generator hours. You can turn the generator on and off from here. and you have your house battery disconnect right here, and you can turn your water pump on from here. Now, just below that, we've got a screen here, so we can start and stop the generator here. We can also go to our auto gen start, and we can go to our settings. So we can do our quiet hours and set that. Start temperature, our voltage, what we want it to, once it hits a certain voltage when we want it to start, run time, and then more. So we can customize our auto gen start settings right there. And then right here is our over the air antenna. As I step up into the Admiral, look at this beautiful interior package. I think that Holiday Rambler does one of the best jobs as far as giving a very residential look. So this is the Elevate interior package. You also have the Camelback that you can choose from. This is the Fossil cabinet color, and then you have two other wood colors that you can choose from. So I just think it looks really nice. Notice the valances, the backsplash, like everything just looks really beautiful and comes together nicely. Then I've turned around the captain and the co-captain's chair so you can see how you can have a nice, you know, group over for dinner, really enjoy each other's company, talk with everyone. You're gonna have seat belts for four. So one, two, and then two in the sofa here. This is the jackknife sofa. So one of the new features for 2025 is the 360 plus HD antenna. Along with that, you get the WineGuard gateway that is 5G ready. So let's go over all the storage that we have in the front cab area. First of all, we've got a nice little storage compartment here with our cargo net, another big area here with the cargo net. I'll explain more about this in a second, but inside here, we have two 110 outlets, and then we have our WineGuard on and off switch right there. Nice big compartment, and that is a pass-through. So you have all of that space, which is really nice. Anything long or you wanna hide something, you can put it right back there. And that's going to connect over to this space here. Nice, huge compartment, like that's massive. And then another cargo net area here and here. So what is so cool about all this space up here is that it's great for your bunk. So this actually is a bunk bed. I don't even think you notice it when you walk into the coach. And I love that, that you have a full extra sleeping area that you don't notice. So it is not only a bunk, but you can also use it as like a safe because you do have to have a key to bring that down. So if you wanna store something up there that's safe, you can easily do that. So just make sure your key is in and in the on position. Now you can bring that down. So now all that storage space that you see your guests that are sleeping on the queen size mattress, yes, I'm not mistaken, queen size mattress, and this bunk bed will support up to 600 pounds. So you have a thin mattress, but it sort of feels like that, you know, a thick Tempur-Pedic, so it feels like it'll be very comfortable. Then we have our ladder, and it goes up super easy too. You're just going to put it in horizontally, and then you slip it down, and then it just locks into place there. Easily step up. And what I wanted to show you was how much space there is. So, I mean, I'm touching, but you know, a lot of times in these overhead bunks, you can't sit up even fully. So I can almost sit up fully. And then you can see just how big that bed is. Easily two adults could fit up here. Also notice that you've got the lights that will turn on automatically when it's fully down. And then we also have a curtain that we can drape across for privacy. And then once you're all done using it, you can just tuck it right away. And now we've got our captain and co-captain's chairs. So this is really nice. It adds to your living room. And the other thing that I like is that we've got a little table here. So we're just gonna take out the little stopper there so that you don't trip in that. Also, while you're sitting here, you've got cup holders. So now you're just gonna take your table leg and you're gonna put it right in there, and then just twist to tighten it so it's nice and sturdy. And then you take your tabletop, put it over the top, and there you go. You have another spot for drinks, cards, you know, dinner, whatever. It's just really nice, kind of adds to the living room feel here. You also have push button lights above the captain and co-captain's chair. Then above our jackknife sofa, look at that storage. Nice big storage compartment. I love that. The hidden hinges, always nice added look so that you just have this very pretty residential cabinet with the nice hardware. We've got our toggle switch here for our LED lights. Beautiful valance, nice big window. I love that. This has a lot of windows, so it does really feel like you can bring the outside in. Love that. Two USB charging ports and two 110 outlets. And then this is the jackknife sofa. So you have two seat belts in there. Check out all that storage right underneath the sofa. So easy to get to. What I'm probably gonna store there will be my bedding for the bunk area and in here, but it's just so nice and easy. So that easy, you've got another bed. So two here, one here, and then you can get two small kids here or one adult here. So I'll make that bed next. Before I make the bed, I wanna talk about the L-shaped dinette. This is what comes standard. If you wanna see what your options are, make sure you give us a call at National Indoor RV Centers where we can custom order a coach for you, exactly like you're wanting. When you're spending this much money, you should get exactly what you want if we don't have what you want on our lot. So we're happy to do that. So you can go ahead and pull the table out or you can turn it too. So if you need it for different use, you can turn it. This is gonna become our bed base. So just unlock it. So if you just want a bigger space here, if you don't need the table, that opens up your space even more. We have our pillows, cute pillows with the Elevate interior package. And now I'm just gonna pull these off. We've got little Velcro tabs to keep those in place. And you have more seat belts. So two more seat belts. So you actually have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 seat belts for this coach. You have four legs and they just screw in. So you just screw them in until they're nice and tight. And this is kind of cool because now I'm just like finding other, you also can have like a little table in front of your jackknife sofa, or you can have a bed. Bed base, multi-use. See, nice, super easy. And then we're gonna grab a cushion. And we have an extra cushion that fills in that space right there. So you could easily get two little kiddos on this bed. Also, when you first walk in, you have a nice little spot there. You can throw items that you need to get to quickly from outside, or if you want to put your muddy shoes there so you don't track everything into the coach. Great little storage spot or cubby. I love the big window. This is 5 feet 4 inches long, but nice big window, and then the MCD blackout shade. And then we have our 40-inch TV. And we've got a little release there so that we can pull that TV out and direct it to wherever is best viewing for ourselves. Underneath the booth, we have two 110 outlets. You've got the vent for the furnace. Then you've got your cable. So if you want to hook up a gaming system, you can do that here. Two more 110 outlets under here and a nice little storage spot. Directly across from it, we've got our CO2 and propane alarm. So heading into the kitchen, notice a nice countertop here. Lots of prep area, and I love the backsplash. Again, very residential look, residential faucet, and I do love that. So you can spray out your whole sink. Very cool. Beautiful cabinets. We've kind of got the, I guess, frosted glass door, but I just think that's super pretty. And I can still, it doesn't have to be perfectly neat in there. adjustable shelves, extra 110 outlet, and then we've got the plug-in for our microwave. Then we have our microwave and our 3-burner gas cooktop. And you can just flip that up. Look at that, super easy, ready to use. When you're not using it, then you're just going to flip that back down, use it as prep space, and you get an oven. So fresh baked cookies coming your way from Angie. It's my specialty. Just ask my husband. It's the only thing I actually make. And then we've got storage here. Nice big drawer below. And we've got some storage underneath the sink. We've got room for some soaps and our brushes. 2 110 outlets with a GFCI switch. And then we've got our water heater so we can set the temperature that we want to have that set at on and off. And then you can say whether you want Celsius or Fahrenheit. Right below that, we have the water heater bypass. So we have the normal flow and the bypass. Nice big round stainless steel sink. And then like I said, lots of counter space and nice big drawers. And you can feel them lock into place so they're not gonna open up during travel. So nice amount of storage in this kitchen. Right across from the kitchen, we've got the 2 110 outlets. And then we have our slide room control for our slide. Now you need to make sure that you have your park brake set. You can have your ignition on or off, doesn't matter, but you do have to have your park brake set to bring that slide in. Right above that, you've got the control for the AC and furnace in this portion of the coach. So you can just turn it to cool, fan, off, or heat, and then your fan, high, low, whatever you want, or auto. Thermistor for the front half of the coach. So that's going to communicate with the thermostat to make sure you keep your coach nice and comfortable. We have the Insignia freezer. Oh, that feels really good. And refrigerator. So nice size refrigerator and freezer. And you've got the safety lock there. So that's one of those things that you need to have. So if you're fairly new to RVing, you may want to check out my RVing 101 series, where I basically plan a trip, start a trip from start to finish, hook up everything, disconnect everything, even cook a few little fun recipes along the way. But you just want to make sure that you have a checklist also. And I talk about that checklist in my RVing 101 series. Want to make sure that someone locks that so that you don't have those doors coming open when you make a turn and have all the contents spill out over your floor. Not a fun way to start a trip. If you want a copy of my pre-trip checklist, just send me an email at angie@nirvc.com. Let's head into our bathroom here. So we have a nice bathroom. This is the midship bath. This is a single bath floor plan. We've got our nice fan here for the bathroom, and we've got storage with adjustable shelves. Always like that for some of my taller bottles. More storage with adjustable shelves. And then great storage here behind your mirror. Love that, nice and tall. I can get my tall hairspray bottles in there, no problem. And then a little trick that you might wanna try, since this is such a big space and you are gonna be traveling. You can get like a little spring bar or rod to go across there so that the contents of this compartment don't all fall out when you open this door. Counter space with a stainless steel bowl, residential faucets, toilet paper holder. Nice little place for our garbage or for toilet paper. Then we have our Dometic toilet with the pedal control, and our light switch is here on the side. Then we step up into our shower. So I am, 5'6" on a good day. Got my heels on, you got your skylight here, so that gives you some extra headroom. And then you've got your handheld wand there, your controls, and your shower miser. So this is really great. This is going to save your freshwater tank and your gray tank. Because basically what it does, instead of wasting water while you're waiting for it to get warm, you're just gonna turn your shower miser to the recirculating position. So that no water is coming out, that means that it's recirculating and getting warm. Once the water is warm, this bulb's gonna light up, and then you just turn the lever here, let the water come out, and it's nice and warm. And you've got the glass shower doors, so you just unhook those. This is another thing that needs to be on your pre-trip checklist. Make sure you lock that into place before you hit the road. And there's your privacy for your shower. 2 110 outlets. And I love that they give you towel hooks on the door. No towels on the ground or on the bed. As we head into the master bedroom, first of all, I love that we've got a decorative mirror here so you can check out your outfit before you head out for the evening. Then you've got your privacy doors. So just undo this they pull shut and you've got a little magnet there, so you have a nice little secure closure. And then again, just make sure that you tie those back when you're traveling so they don't come open. Nice big king bed here and nice plush pillow top mattress. And check out all the storage below. That's the biggest underbed storage I have ever seen. Plenty of room for your ladder and lots, lots more. Note the beautiful interior package, bedspread, and then our headboard. We've got our reading lights. We've got the control, just a little push button control on both sides. And you've got speakers on both sides too, because you do have a radio back here in the bedroom area. Now, check out these cabinets above the bed. So these are giving Tiffin a run for their money. I always say that Tiffin has like the most storage, the biggest cabinets, but these may be the biggest overbed cabinets that I've ever seen. So nice big cabinets. Let me just pull out the measuring tape here. So the opening is 17 inches. Inside the compartment, it is almost 20 inches tall. And it is about 14 and a half inches deep. And there's no divider. So you have this whole space here all the way across. Another thing I like about this space is that I can actually reach everything. So not only is it a really big space, but I can access it. So you have a nice end table on both sides or nightstand, but you know, big enough space that you can put a CPAP machine if you need to, or your books and your, you know, your drink, your glasses. I love that. So here is the rear radio for the bedroom, which is super nice. And then below that, you've got 2 110 outlets, 2 USB charging ports. And then on the bed base here, we have our breaker box and fuse panel, and everything's nicely labeled. So let's check out all the storage across from the bed. First of all, you know that I love windows. So I love to be laying in bed, looking out the window, beautiful park, ocean, mountain, wherever I am. But then you can easily black that out for privacy as well. We have our 32 inch TV, and we have one additional outlet here, 2 110 outlets here, 2 USB charging ports. And then we've got our AC heat controls for the bedroom and our light control for the bedroom. Nice counter space here, and then check out these drawers. They're massive. They're so big, nice and deep. I'm telling you, this coach has a ton of storage, which I absolutely love. And then you've got the nice big wardrobe here. Look how huge that is. So 2 hanging bars, really nice. So I love to show the floor plan with the slides in, or the slide in. So you can see you easily can get to your king size bed and sleep in it without taking the slides out. No problem getting to the refrigerator and the freezer. I can open up the door all the way. So that's really nice. Full access to the bathroom. Like, this just has tons of space. When you're traveling down the road, obviously you can sit in the jackknife sofa. You can even jackknife it out if you want to. So very roomy. All right, so finally to the cockpit area. First of all, I want to tell you that the chairs are very comfy. So we've got our armrests here. We can put them up or down, and then we can adjust our backrest. And then over to the right, I have the controls for the power seat. So forward, back, and then forward, up and down, or rear, up and down. And then under the skirting here to my right, I've got the lever that's going to allow me to turn my chair into the living room. So super easy to control there. So here to my left, I have a nice little ledge chair, cup holder, storage down below. If you're like me and like to have an atlas for backup in case, you know, you don't have service, it's kind of nice. We have a speaker here for the radio. And then up above here, we've got our traction control. We can turn that off. Our hazard lights. Then we've got our lights here, so we can turn them off. Then we've got our running lights, our headlights, or we have the auto lights. And then we have the minus and plus here. That's going to be your dash, so you can dim or brighten the dash settings. Above here, we've got the control for our front shade up and down. And then we have our auxiliary start button, which is super important. So let's say that you've been at Disneyland all day, had a great time, come back to the coach, can't start it. That's a bummer, right? So what you want to do is take your chassis and your house batteries, tie them together, get enough power to start your engine. If that doesn't work, push the battery boost, see if you get enough power so you can start your generator, let your generator run, charge things back up, and then you should be able to start your coach. So very important button there. Then we have the controls for our exterior mirrors, so we can adjust those, and the defrost for our mirrors. Then we have the speaker and microphone to connect our phone with and for voice commands. And then right down below, we've got the park brake. So to set that, you're just gonna push down. To release it, you're just gonna pull up and push down to set. Then here on the column itself, you can adjust the position of the steering column, just like you do in your auto. So get that nice and comfortable for you. Then we have our turn signal controls here. We can do our windshield wipers from here, push in for the windshield wiper fluid, and then you can set the speed of the windshield wipers, and then you can flash your headlights by either pushing back or pulling them forward. So here we've got the controls that control the information we can see up on the screen here. So we've got our main menu, and we can click up or down. So we're gonna click up to that triple one, and then I'm gonna click into it, and I can get all the information by clicking down for trip one, and then I can click back trip two, fuel economy, driver assist. So we have our engine hours, voltmeter, maintenance monitor, that's gonna give you your oil life. So then we have our program range selection. So this is gives you the ability when you're driving that you can reduce the number of gears available to you. So if you are in a slippery situation or steep incline when you are towing, you can, it will help assist you. Settings, so you have your vehicle settings, your lighting, so you can do your auto lamp delay, daytime light, or you can click that on and off. Ford pass, and then your units, temperature, language, just customize your screen information there. So super easy to use. And then below that, you've got your cruise control, so on and off, and then you can set it. And then once you've set it, you can go up or down in speed, resume and cancel. Your horns in the center, ignition to the side. So then you have the paddle here so that you can shift into different gears. Tow haul mode is gonna reduce the stress on your braking by keeping you in a lower gear, kind of like acting as like an engine brake almost. And then you've got the plus and the minus. That's how you're gonna adjust that program range selection when you're in that portion of it. Next up is the electronic leveling system. So this you're going to level. You're just gonna power it on, and then you're gonna hit auto level. And so it will level front to back and then left to right. When you get a solid green light here, that means you're level. If you can't level, it's gonna let you know that you're on an excessive slope and you may need to move your coach and then try again. Once you've done that like twice, give it about a 20-minute rest so that you're not burning up your pump. You can also manually level if you need to, bring the front up a little bit or the rear. So you just press into this and then hit the arrows up or down. When it's time to leave, you're just gonna go ahead and hit retract. They're gonna bring the jacks up and you'll be ready to go. So it's super easy. You're absolutely gonna love that. Now, next to that, we have a USB charging port, but that is also the port that allows you to plug into your CarPlay system. So you'll get a message on your phone, CarPlay, and then it's gonna pop up right here on your front dash. So if you wanna use Waze or Google for navigation, super easy to do that with Apple CarPlay or Android Auto. So up here on our screen, we have our kind of homepage. This is our radio, our AV, Bluetooth, you can connect your phone, USB, Sirius XM, Android Auto or Apple CarPlay, and then your phone. You can click into your radio settings there, super easy. Go back to the source, AV. Bluetooth, you've got your Bluetooth audio, camera. So that's your rear view camera view. And then scroll over one more page for your settings. And you've got your audio and video display settings here, so you can customize your screen. Then we have our generator on and off, and then our radio. So right now we've got it in the travel mode. Once we're not traveling, we may still want to play our radio from the dash. So we're just going to put it in park mode here. Then we're going to come down below. Again, we've got the two USB charging ports, two 12 volt ports. And then our AC and heat controls and the airflow controls. Then we've got a nice storage compartment here, two quick USB charging ports, the three cup holder, and another little storage space. So the co-captain's chair is just as comfy, and you can, you know, recline it back as much as you like, get nice and comfortable. It is not powered, so you do have to just move the lever around to turn it, just like we did on the captain's chair. So here right in front of me, nice little space here. But then I also have a little workstation. I can put my iPad up here as we're going down the road, or my map, you know, so I can kind of navigate. I like that. And then we have a little cubby here with more storage. And we have a little tray. So, you know, I could put that on my lap and have my own little lunch. Or you can have it here. Got storage compartment here, and then the storage here. It just fits nicely back in there. And I know a ton of us RV so that we can take our pets along with us, and we have a pet friendly window right here so they can sit up by our feet and watch the countryside as we go around. And then we have the two 110 outlets, and then we have a speaker for the co-captain, and storage compartment here, and drink holder. It's finally time for my favorite part, the test drive. Now, I think it's so important that you test drive whatever you're driving. We feel that at National Indoor RV Center. So when you come to do your research and try things out, make sure you take your favorite coach for a test drive. Getting ready to drive, this is super easy. It's a gas coach, so your tires are out in front of you. You fit in the lane. You're bigger than most things on the road, so just take it slow and easy and you're gonna have no problems. Your mirrors are your saving grace, so you're just gonna watch those. If your tires are gonna hit the curb, you're gonna see it, so don't worry about that. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so as we get started here, some of the things that I was taught when I first started driving RVs is that you want to hug the left side of the lane that you're traveling in. So right now we're on a little road leading into National Indoor RV Centers in Nashville, Tennessee. So there is no dividing line, but as soon as I get out in the road, you want to hug the left side of the lane that you are traveling in. More bad things happen on the right. Tree limbs, they can be very costly, very expensive. Road debris, street signs, things that you have to watch out for when you're driving a big coach like this, and that you really don't think about when you're driving a car. But it's a great way to travel. You get to sleep in your own bed, you get to cook your own meal if you want, otherwise you get to try new restaurants. But after you've been on the road for a while, sometimes it's nice just to be able to cook your own meal. I know when I travel a lot for work, and I love when I get home and I'm able to cook my own meal. It's a nice option. So you've got nice pickup with the Ford engine. It is a little noisier than our diesels just because your engine is up front, so you would expect that, but really not a problem. You can still have a conversation with your co-pilot as you're traveling down the road. Man, it's been such a beautiful day for videoing, beautiful evening here in Tennessee. And National Indoor RV Centers also wants to plan your first trip for you, or one of your trips. So when you purchase from us, you become a member of the all-inclusive Motorhome Club. And we hold rallies across the country, and we try to give our customers an experience like they wouldn't have, you know, if they went on their own. We really want to give you opportunity to use your coach and then have a lot of fun, meet new people, hang out with us. I get to go to all the rallies. I have such the best job in the whole industry. I am very blessed. So make sure you check out our AIM rallies. It's aimclub.org. All right, so if you happen to hit one of those tree limbs or a fire hydrant or a picnic table or a rock, you know, it's amazing how some of these things just kind of jump out at you. And you need some paint and body work, make sure that National Indoor RV Center is your first call. We will help you with your insurance company. We have artists that literally will make your coach as good as new, and we warranty our work for life. So make sure you give us a call if you ever have a boo-boo in your coach, which most likely is gonna happen. If you use your coach and enjoy it, you'll have something that happens at some point in time. So if you know me, if you've watched my videos before, you know that I always do the decibel reader so you can see how quiet it is in the cockpit. So 65.4 is not bad at all for a gas coach with the engine up front. Thank you so much for joining me today on the tour of the 2025 Holiday Rambler Admiral 29M. Now, I'm sure you're wondering how much this gorgeous coach would cost you. Well, current MSRP is $182,400. If you want to know how much I can sell it to you for, make sure you give us a call at National Indoor RV Centers. With our volume and economies of scale, RVs simply cost less with National Indoor RV Centers. And we want to make the buying process fun and easy. This is a recreational vehicle. You should be having fun. We take in trades. We do consignments. You can finance this for up to 20 years. So what are you waiting for? If there's anything that customers have told me over and over again is that they wish they would have done this sooner. And this is so affordable. So give us a call today. If you've enjoyed this video and you'd like to see more like it, please hit the like and subscribe. Also go check out my RVing 101 series, our AIM Club, and our Paint and Body. Thank you so much and have a wonderful day.